As there are 7 days in a week, we know that each day is repeated after 7 days. So if on the first of the month, if it was Sunday, then on the eighth of that month, again it will be Sunday. And 15th of the month, it will be Sunday again, because a day is repeated after 7 days. So we have to find a multiple of 7 which is closest to the number of days that is given in the example. So in this example, we have given starting day as a Sunday, and what is asked is after 45 days, what would be day? So we have to find out the multiple of 7 which is close to 45. And the easiest way to find that out is divide 45 by 7, and whatever is the remainder is the number that we are interested in. So if Rahul's birthday is on Sunday, Ashwin's birthday will come these many days after Sunday, that is Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. So Ashwin's birthday would be on Wednesday. Sunrise is at 6:32 a.m. and if sunset happens after 11 hours and 47 minutes, then the question is, at what time does sunset happen? So essentially what we want to add is to add 6:32 plus 11:47 hours to derive the timing of sunset. So let's add the minutes first, yeah, which is 32 plus 47, so 79 minutes. But we know 60 minutes is 1 hour. So 79 minutes becomes 79 minus 60 minutes and 1 hour, because that 60 minutes become 1 hour. So 79 minutes is 1 hour and 19 minutes. Now let's add hours. So we have 6 hours, 11 hours and this additional 1 hour, which becomes 6 plus 11 plus 1, which is equal to 18 hours. But in a day there are only 12 hours. So sunset would be at 18 minus 12 hours and 19 minutes. So it will be at 6:19 p.m. This is Sahil and this is Reena. Both are starting from 0 and Sahil is counting in multiples of 6. So he will say 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, so on and so forth. While Reena will say 8, 16, 24, 32, 40, so on and so forth. The question is, what is the first number that both of them will say as they count? So if you see the numbers, you see the first number that they will say is 24.
The answer is 24. Another way to solve this problem is what essentially we are trying to do here is found the least common multiple of these two numbers, 6 and 8. So if you calculate the LCM 6 and 8, that should give us the same answer. So let's try to calculate the LCM of 6 and 8. 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1. So LCM is 2 into 2 into 3 into 2, which is 24. Arun has 5 boxes each weighing 250 grams. So he has 5 boxes each 250 grams. So the total weight of boxes which Arun has is 250 into 5, which is 1250 grams, while for Bharat he has 7 boxes of 150 grams each. So total weight of boxes that Bharat has is 150 into 7, which is 1050 grams. So clearly Arun has got more weight, and his weight is more by 1250 minus 1050, which is 200 grams. So the correct option is Bharat has 200 gram less than Arun. Try to draw here a dragon, which probably looks more like a kangaroo, but assume it's a dragon, and that way it's a flying dragon. So this is the portion till its head, and this is the rest of the body. So let's try to solve this problem by means of equation. If we assume the head to be x centimeter long, the body would be x plus 460 centimeters, because the body is longer than head by 460 centimeter. And what is also given is the total length of dragon is 740. So which means body plus head is equal to total length, which also means head is x and body is x plus 460, and the total length that is given is 740 centimeters. So which is 2x plus 460 is 740. So we have a 2x is equal to 280 centimeters. So x is equal to 140 centimeter. So the head of dragon is 140 centimeters. Another way to solve this problem is by indirect method, where we take each of the option given and try to see whether, if we use that option, whether it fits into the equation properly. So head is given, based on that we can calculate the length of the body, and there's a total length of a dragon, say. So option one, if head is 120, the body is going to be 120 plus 460, which is 580, and total length would be 580 plus 120, which is 700, which is not equal to 740 as we expect. So that's the wrong choice. The second choice given is 140. Head is 140. So obviously the body is going to be 140 plus 460, which is 600 centimeter. So total is going to be 600 plus 140, which is 740. And this is the total length of a dragon. So this sounds like a right answer. So let's first try to understand how many houses from number 1 to 100 will have digit 3. So we know there will be 10 numbers where 3 is in unit place, that is 3, 13, 23, 33, 43, 53, 63, 73, 83, and 93. And there would be 10 numbers where there will be 3 in tens place. So these are 10, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, and 39. So these are 10 numbers, and these are 10 numbers. But we can see that this number 33 is common at the both place, so it's double counted. So we need to deduct one number from the summation of these two. So this 10 plus 10 becomes 20, and we need to subtract 1 for number 33, which is counted twice. So effectively there are 19 numbers which contain a number 3 in some place. So if the houses have to start after 100, they will go, and 19 have to be added, those house number will go till 119. But wait a minute, from 1 to 119, again there should not be any houses which contain number 3. So, and how many such numbers will be there? There will be 103, and there will be 113. So these two houses are there which again need to go beyond 119. So our new numbers would be 1 to 119, excluding 103 and 113. So those new numbers will be 120 and 121. So the maximum house number would be 121. So these are the three arrow bags which contains various arrows of this great hunter. And what has been mentioned that 18 arrows were removed from bag A, 9 arrows were removed from bag B, and 1 arrow was added to bag C. Yes, and after doing all that, all three bags contain same number of arrows. And the question is, how many arrows were there originally in each bag? So what we need to understand, after removing 18 arrows from A, 9 arrows from B, and adding C, adding 1 arrow to C, now they're at same place. But in the beginning, A definitely had 9 arrows more than B, because after removing 18 and after removing 9, they're at the same place, which means A had 9 arrows more than B in the first place, which means A minus B, if we had done earlier, we would have got 9 arrows. Similarly, 9 arrows were removed from B and 1 arrow was added to C, and then they become same, which means in the first place B had 10 arrows more than C. So B minus C would have been become 10, because remember 9 were removed from B and 1 was added to C. So B had a loss of 9, C had a gain of 1, and then they became the same number. So earlier, if we'd have taken the difference, then B minus C would have been 10, correct? And Similarly, A minus C, if we had taken, it would have been 19, because 18 were removed from A, 1 was added to C. So in the beginning, A minus C would have been 19. Now let's take each of the option and see whether they satisfy all these criteria. In the first option, A is 44, B is 35, and C is 25. So if you do A minus B, it will be A is 44, B is 35. So A minus B is 9, that meets our requirement. B minus C is 35 minus 25, which is 10. It meets our requirement. And third is A minus C 19? 44 minus 25 is 19. So the correct option is A. The correct option is 1, sorry. So in the market you get one orange, assume it's orange, yeah. So you get one orange for three bananas is equal to three bananas. So these are three bananas. It's a little hard to believe, but believe they are bananas, yes. An apple for two oranges. So if we take apple, so let's try to have apple like that with, yeah, this is apple. So apple has two oranges, so within one apple you get two oranges, as I shown earlier. So you get two oranges and you also get two bananas. Right. So the question is, to get two apples, how many bananas would you have to give? So this is what one apple is. So in order to get one, let's see, for one apple, how many bananas you need. So to get one apple, you need two oranges, and in each orange, you need to get three bananas. So this one orange will give you three bananas. This another orange will give you another set of three bananas. And anyway, these two bananas are anyway needed. So effectively, one apple will give you eight bananas. So two apples will give you 16 bananas. Each cow has one head and four legs. So total for each cow is 5. So assume that we have X number of cows. So total parts that they will have is X into 5, which is given as 100. So X is equal to 100 divided by 5. Which is 20. So the answer is there will be 20 cows, and let's try to see if our answer is correct. So 20 cows will have 20 heads, and they will have 20 into 4 legs. So effectively sum of the head and legs will be 20 plus 80, which is 100. So our answer seems correct. So assume this is this giant, yeah. This is small Gulliver. So when giant makes three steps, yeah, 1, 2, and 3, Gulliver has to make 15 steps. Right. So one step of giant is equal to 15 by 3 steps of Gulliver. So one step of giant is 5 steps of Gulliver. So if giant has taken 42 steps, Gulliver will have to take 42 into 5 equal to 210 steps. The fundamental principle we need to remember in this kind of example is, as the year increases, the day of the same date increases progressively. That is, if today is 23rd October 2014 is a Thursday, then 23rd October 2015 would be Friday, 23rd October 2016 is Saturday. Now the only change is, if the year appears to be a leap year, then it won't be just addition of one day but 2 days, because as we know, the leap year has 266 days, so we need to add 2 days instead of 1 day. So going by the same logic, if 15th Jan 1996 is Monday, then 15th Jan 2000 is going to be Monday plus 4. But as 1996 was a leap year, we need to give that additional day. So it will be Monday plus 5 days, which means 15th Jan 2000 would be a Saturday. But wait a second, 2000 is also a leap year, so why don't we add that? So that we won't do, because we are talking about 15th Jan, and the effect of leap year will only come after February. So that leap year does not have any bearing on this calculation. Let's try to apply all the conditions which have been given here. So the first condition is, this number is odd. So this column has gone because it has got all even numbers. This column has gone, it has all even numbers. And this column has gone because it has got even numbers. Then it says the second condition, it is a multiple of 3. So this column will go because it doesn't have anything which is multiple of 3. This column doesn't have anything which is multiple of 3. It is smaller than 7 into 4. 7 into 4 is 28. So now we have just this one column where we have got our answer. This number is smaller than 28. So this is gone. So this number has to be one of these numbers. Its 10 digit is even. These two do not have any tens digits, so those are gone. This has a tens digit, but it is not even, so this is gone. So we have got only two numbers, 21 and 27. And as mentioned, it is greater of two possibilities. So two possibilities are 21 and 27, and it is greater of two possibilities. So correct answer is 27. Total number of student students is 35. Out of that, girls are 25. So number of boys are 10. That is 35 minus 25 is equal to 10. Now number of boys with no glasses is equal to 7. So number of boys with glasses is equal to total number of boys minus number of boys with no glasses, which is 10 minus 7, which is equal to 3. Now, total number of students in a class with glasses is equal to 12. So, number of girls with glasses is equal to total number of students with glasses, that is 12, minus total number of boys with glasses, 3, that is equal to 9. So there are 9 girls with glasses in the class. Smallest number divisible by 8 and 12 is essentially the LCM of two of the numbers. So taking LCM of 8 and 12, so LCM is equal to 4 into 2 into 3, which is 24. So the smallest whole number divisible by both 8 and 12 is 24. Let's try to draw how a clock will look at 9:30. It looks something like this. So minute hand would be on 6 and hour hand would be somewhere between 9 and 10. And we know at 9 o'clock sharp, if it had been at 9 o'clock, if the hourglass has been on 9 here, then we would have exactly right angle. And as the hour hand is between 9 and 10, this angle is going to be slightly bigger than a right angle triangle, which is nothing but obtuse angle. So the correct answer is at 9:30 you will see obtuse angle in the clock.